Good morning. Since the last clip where we destroyed the steering pump on the trail, we've replaced the pump and I've put the full-size steering wheel back on. We're chugging along here. What I'm looking to test today is I've got another main top leaf in the rear springs. I've got it made up a little bit differently to the last one. It's pushed the back diff back probably 15 mil to give me a better shackle angle. Trying to get a little bit more flex out of the springs. So that's what we're trying to achieve today. We're out to make sure that I've taken the spacer off the shaft and I've put a different shaft on. I'm going to make up another shaft. So I'm just out here to make sure I've got enough spline and also just to lock the hubs and maybe push some locker buttons. So when the pump went, I thought, oh yeah, this would be an easy fix. But they aren't. They're a mission to get hold of. It all seems to be good. We've driven here, we've driven a few little hills. I did just set it up and bleed it quickly again because I thought maybe there was a bit more air in it. The housing's where the holes go through. They elongate and eventually it snaps the bolt. So, you know, to find a pump is one thing, to find one where the housing hole is still round is another. well and truly on his chassis. Difference between the Treps and the 35s is that. We actually haven't tested the Treps with the new suspension setup I've put in, but if it's going to hit, it's really only going to hit the chassis. So it and that's the back, so it should be okay. But we'll dust the cobwebs off the Treps, get it on the car trailer, and organise a social. Get some of the boys out. Everyone's keen. Do one or two runs now, probably one before the next comp. And once again, thanks for watching. Thank you.